Hey, what's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Brendan Bird. I really just want to get on here. Actually, it was a little bit kind of quick. I want to touch on about the Super Bowl ads that, that was been running along during the Super Bowl. And there was a lot of disrespect, a lot of blatantly, a lot of underline, but a lot of sneak type of disrespect towards the black legends. You know what I'm saying? Two particular. One was Prince, the second was Martin Luther King Jr. You know, what can I say? I mean, the two people that actually gave the diss, I mean, how dare they even diss? One was a corporate, and one was a goddamn culture vulture. You know what I'm saying? Justin Timberfake, I like to call him. But yeah, he did. Actually, when he did his halftime, he actually had a cameo of Prince music and some of his imagery being displayed during the halftime show. Also, too, Dawes used part of Martin Luther King's speech. The Dream speech, and it was another reference speech that they used. And to me, that's like an underlying statement to black people, like, well, it was kind of like one of those, like, hey, man, here's a little doggy bone, so you guys can shut up and go back to the status quo. But hopefully more than myself, but I know there's probably a good few million brothers and sisters that recognize those underlying disses to our black legends. I definitely didn't care for that. Definitely Timberlake. I never respected him since the last Super Bowl, what he did to Janet Jackson. Never really stuck up for her. He never manned up to say it was his mistake. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, it was my mistake. I tore it off, but no, she got ridiculed. And he's back in America graces. So that lets you know how much they really care about a black person, even how much money they got, how much fame they got, or white or versa or whatsoever. You know what I'm saying? It's something like what Trick Daddy said. You can be a millionaire, big house, Cadillac truck, but you're still a nigger. Pure and simple. Dawes have no right to use whatever speech from MLK, because he wasn't about that. He wasn't about corporation. He wasn't about profit. You know, he wasn't about really all that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you forgot he had the poor people campaign. You know what I'm saying? So he was trying to uplift classes and try to create an equality and plus to even justify playing field for all classes. So the poor class can go up to the rich class and so forth, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Corporation was not really behind that poor people campaign. So for Dawes, a corporation giant that should have went belly up, but was saved of public tax money, basically that's what it was, should never even used his speech in the first place. And to use it in a purpose of also to make profit, that's all it was. They used it to make profit. They want to sell cars. Car dealerships is one of the most illegal hustling type of job. You sell your goddamn soul to sell a goddamn vehicle. You know what I'm saying? So it was just a lot of stuff, man, I did not like. I'm glad I did not watch that Super Bowl. I'm glad I boycotted the NFL. I mean, it was kind of hard because I know I'm a Steeler fan. But, you know, I'm like I said, man, I think it's a lot of false. It's a lot of wrongs going on that I'm not going to partake in that. At all. Not going to partake. But like I said, I mean, I'm going to get my money. Like I said, I'm at work. I'm grinding. You know what I'm saying? I have to roll out. I don't really care about no Super Bowl. I really don't care about much holidays, man. Most of these, like I said, some of these holidays, it's come from Pegasus origin. Valentine's Day, maybe I'm not going to even want to celebrate that because I searched the history on Valentine's Day. And, man, it's the most disgusting. It's the most disgusting vow type of ritual you ever will hear or read. I mean, but I'm gonna tell you a little bit about it. I'll probably talk about it when you know Valentine come. But man, it's just, like I said, a lot of these holidays, especially in America, it's not really good. If you go behind the actual some of these holidays, you'll never want to ever celebrate not one more holiday. But yeah, man, I definitely was like Justin Timberlake. Like I said, he's a culture vulture, man. I know what there's actually. If you remember Star Search, and I used to, you know, believe me, that was back in the day. That was like I forgot who. Dude, the host, the guy that used to do the Star Search, he actually used to be a co-host for the in the jar. I think the Johnny Carson show. So he, you know, this is going way back. I mean, this is going back like I think damn near close to the 80s, like the late mid 80s. I think it stopped around the early 90s, like 91, 92 was like, I think it's like the last time, like one of the last seasons. But, yeah, man, yeah, he was actually on there. And he wasn't singing no blues. He wasn't doing no rock and roll. He wasn't doing none of that. He was doing country. The dude had cowboy hats, cowboy boots, you know, the flannels, everything. He was cowboy up, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I think he just, like I said, I think originally he, you know, he probably looked at black music like it was pretty cool. You know, he had maybe a little bit of talent. You know, I think like, you know, Chris Brown's a whole lot better, but, you know, I mean, I don't think he started in the soul, in soul music or whatever he proclaimed. Like I said, when he was at that talent show, man, he was cowboy up. The dude was like just hee-haw and shit. I still remember that. You know what I'm saying? Even when he was part of Mickey Mouse Club, there was nothing in my mind that he was rocking to some black music. You know what I'm saying? Maybe he was, but, you know, I mean, he not really just embraced the culture. You can like music, but you ain't really embraced the culture. You know what I'm saying? But it's just like I said, it's just a lot of disrespect going on. You know what I'm saying? Not just from the dominant society, but other racial groups. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people, like I said, man, need to stop this cooning and really, really develop and get on code. You know what I'm saying? Take care of the people within your fam and your community. You know what I'm saying? So that's pretty much what it is. But I seen the little, Kevin Hart. He's cool. He got denied. I don't know why his goofy short ass was even on the field. He's actually lucky they didn't whoop his ass and carry them off the field. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know what Kevin Hart was doing. I think Kevin Hart is from Philly, but man, dude, you ain't no like main figure. You still a black man, dude. And I think a lot of black people sometimes forget it, man. You still a black man. You are still a nigger. I interact with a lot of people from the dominant society. And there is some cool white people, but as a collective, some is on code. Some is voluntarily, some is involuntary. You know what I'm saying? So but they're on code. But yeah, man, like I said, man, I'll catch you guys a little bit later. I'm about to go and make this money, get my way up to Oklahoma City, and I'll hit you guys up like tomorrow. All right, one.